on that occasion. You see Dodds with the ball in the control, laid it back towards Connor, then took a thumping tackle late. Robertson's header, here's Davy Dodds. Now Connor. Offered one for Stuart Munro. Scraps picked up by Dodds. Here's Miller. Oh, good play by Miller. A fine cross. It was Nicol who did well for Rangers. And Woods takes it off the head of Jimmy Nicol again. Well, a death blow to Jimmy Nicol. There's no doubt about that. Connor would have cashed in. But it was delightful play on the right from Joe Miller, which set it all up. Look at the way he took on Stuart Munro. Sped to the byline. A superb outswinging cross. Connor was coming in. And a fine leap by Jimmy Nicol saved the day for Rangers. A very sure footed again, challenging Cooper. Leash into space ahead. And there with Butcher. Big kick against Butcher. And Dodds felt the full brunt of that challenge. Aberdeen pressing forward now in the closing minutes of the first half. The free kick will be taken by Alec McLeish. That's towards Dodds. There's Robertson. A good snapshot from the youngster. But Woods was very alert. And you can see again an example of the problems posed by Davy Dodds in the air. The long ball from McLeish. Dodds got a touch. That snapshot from Robertson almost caught out the Rangers defence. There's Dodds. Now Connor. Heading for the byline. That's a good cross again. Up goes Miller. Starts into the box. And Derek Ferguson gets it back to Woods. The Aberdeen fans looking for a foul against Ferguson, but holding off Stark. The referee's not interested. That's a fine play over that left flank from Connor. He did extremely well to send over that teasing cross. Joe Miller getting up well. And Stark was just waiting for the ball. The ball finally by him. But at the other end, the free kick to Rangers. A late opportunity to find an equaliser. And some activity off the ball inside the box. Davy Dodds has been sent spinning and the referee is now going over towards the linesman on the far side. Oh, I didn't see what happened there. The free kick was about to be taken. There's the linesman, Mr. Harris from Lift, having a word with Tommy Muirhead. And I fancy now that Rangers may well be facing the prospect of losing a player. Five may well mean that David McPherson. And the only possible decision surely could be an ordering off, because that was certainly with the ball dead. Referee Muirhead calling David McPherson to him. Now this is a moment of drama at the Tawdry. In the last minute of the first half, David McPherson clashing with David Dodds off the ball. The linesman has identified him to the referee and the red card is shown to the Rangers centre-half. The match will restart with a free kick to Rangers, taken by Cooper, headed out by Betts. The danger still not over. McLeish nodding it out. There's Munro. Referee Muirhead, I'm sure, will be anxious to score for half time. He's done so. And what a dramatic end to the first half. David Dodds was off wounded. He was the man who got the vital goal in the 19th minute, which has given Aberdeen the lead. It came after an error in defence by Stuart Munro, hurried into trouble inside his own box. Stuart went in and goalkeeper Woods, a good save initially, but Dodds knocked home the rebound to give Aberdeen the half-time lead, which they just about deserve. It's Aberdeen 1, Rangers second half. Peter Pataudry a goal behind and reduced to only 10 men. And Walter Smith and Graeme Souness in the Rangers dressing room at half-time had the opportunity to make some alterations to cope with their shortage of Dave McPherson. They've done so by means of playing Terry Butcher alongside Cammy Fraser in central defence and bringing Davy Cooper back into a central position in midfield. David Dodds with the damage inflicted apparently by the head of Dave McPherson just on the half-time whistle. Saw the big centre-half ordered off. This is Dougie Bell. Cooper with the return pass. Promising position for Rangers with Bell at the byline. Well tackled by Connor. And Rangers with the corner kick. one link upwardly around the stadium, basically in favour now of Rangers. Butcher has gone forward all right. No point in hanging back with one goal deficit. There's Butcher! And a chance for Boogie Bell. Ollie McCoyce was all around the chance. Butcher did so well with this high ball. Look at the way he attacks the ball in the air, nods it down firmly, came straight to McCoyce, and he didn't catch the shot properly. Corner now for Aberdeen. Joe Miller calling for the ball. Hugging that right wing for the time being. Brett with two and lots of space on the left. And the referee decides that was a dive. And I think the Aberdeen fans may be justified in their hostile reaction to that decision. Well, if we look at that again, John Hewitt committing his man, going past him on the outside. Well, that appeared to be a penalty kick. It's missed by Robertson. Here's Davy Cooper. Now Durant. And a very important tackle in the end by Stuart McKimmy. Durant covering a lot of ground to get in the end of that pass. Kimmy on the right. There's Hewitt. Way inside Fraser and Monroe. Fraser full stretch. Miller playing it against Durant. There's Hewitt. That's for Connor. Great chance for Aberdeen. The ball was running away from Connor all the time. Well, Dougie Bell appeared to have done a good covering job, but he got into trouble in the end as Hewitt flighted this ball across, slanting it into the box. Connor chasing in with Bell, and eventually it broke off Connor upwardly beyond Woods and behind for the goal kick. So Robert Fleck coming on, the number 8, signifies Dougie Bell, who's going off. Well, that's a positive move from Rangers, putting on Fleck as a striker to replace midfield player Dougie Bell. So Pataudry strangely quiet for the moment. Rangers fans, I think, feel that the task may be beyond the favourites, and Aberdeen fans content to wait for the full-time whistle. Here's Timmy Nicol. Connor who intercepts. Good play from the international midfield player. Now John Hewitt has a chance to go at Butcher. There's a header from Miller. Holds his head in his hands, Joe Miller. It was an excellent chance, but he made it easy in the end for Chris Woods. Here's Ferguson. Can they snatch the dramatic late equaliser? Davy Cooper. Now Monroe. Cooper again. Lord Fleck. Connor got the ball first ahead of Ferguson. Now Robertson. Tackled by Nicol. Still Jimmy Nicol, but a free kick's been given. Challenged by Stark, I think, has been penalised. So now going into time, added on for stoppages. The whistling you hear anxiously around the stadium is coming from the Aberdeen supporters. Here's Nicol. Cooper plays it in. Brave header again by McKimmy. A Waited